In this session, we're going to take a look at some of the different touch points with Timberline Estimating and the program by OnCenter called OnScreen Takeoff. OnScreen Takeoff, there are other sessions on it, so I'm not going to go through very much as far as how to do takeoff or anything of that nature, but basically what I want to do is basically show how to take information from this program to bring over dimensions and so forth into my estimate. So here in this particular case, I'm just looking at a particular project. I've got some different walls taken off on and things of that nature, and here's all the different dimensions associated with the different walls and that type of thing. So there's a couple different ways of bringing this information over and into estimating. So I'm actually going to go through two different methods of bringing this information over. One method is to bring all the numbers in and then tell it where you want to use it. And then there's another method that allow you to basically point at something in OnScreen Takeoff and tell it where it needs to go in estimating. So for this first one, I'm going to bring all these different wall dimensions over in one shot and so forth. So as I go through here, and I've got basically six different wall types, it looks like I've only got dimensions for five of those and type of thing. In OnScreen Takeoff, if I go back to my list of bids, here's that sample project right here. If I right-hand click on that, I could tell it that I want to export the information to a bid package. And in this case, I don't care about the images and so forth. Oops, did I do that right? Try it again. Right-click, export, takeoff file. So the takeoff file then is where do you want to put this information. So this file is just a file that has all the different dimensions in it. So in my case, I'm going to go ahead and put it to where my estimating information is associated, or a little bit closer to that folder anyway. Some settings, all users, estimating, and I'm just going to put it out here in this folder, sample project 39. That's basically what the file is going to be called at this point. So I could just hit save, and that's basically created a file that has all the dimensions of that project and it's put out to a place that I could pick it up with estimating. So if I go into estimating then, go up to view, edit dimension list, this little button here will let me bring those dimensions in. So when I click on it, it'll ask me for what do I want some different columns to be. So you get a little bit of option here that you could bring over some different folders or some other different information about it and so forth. All I did in this particular real basic project is just set up some condition names, what quantities I want to come over. So all I did is really just the lino footage of each one of those walls. So quantity one is all I really have at the moment. So once I hit OK, it's going to say, where's the project at? So basically, that's the same path that I was just at. There's a project that I just dumped it out to. And that's going to go through now and actually bring those projects or bring those conditions into this estimate that I'm looking at. And oh, was it done there yet? Okay, that's fine. Retry. So there's basically each one of my different wall types that had dimensions. It skipped the third one since it didn't have any dimensions. So there's my wall type 1, 2, 4, 5, and 6. Right here in estimating. So now what I can do is if I was in doing some takeoff, let's say I was actually taking off some walls, and let's go out to maybe an exterior wall, and it wants to know the wall length. If I right-hand click in that list and actually tell it to recall dimension, that'll pull up the dimension list of all the different dimensions that I measured from the on-screen takeoff. It will also show me that it was done with on-screen takeoff and let me click on it, and it will actually bring back where that number came from. So that way I could tell there's where that dimension is. It's wall type 1. It's the blue lines. So then I could go back through and actually look through my different images for any of the wall type 1 or the blue lines to tell where those numbers had come from and so forth. So if I go through there and actually pick that, it'll automatically put that dimension in for me. And now I could go off and answer the rest of my questions about the makeup of that wall and so forth. So whether or not I need pressure treated plate and whatever the other questions of my assembly may be and so forth. So if I was ready to do another wall, I could do the same thing. I could right hand click, say recall dimension. Maybe I want to bring my wall type 2 in now, a 46 foot. And same thing. Now I could go off and answer how that one's maybe a little bit different of a type wall. So now I can go back and actually see each wall that I've taken off and so forth. And as I go through and just right-hand click and say recall dimension list, it'll just keep a list of all those different dimensions that came over. And the ones I've brought over right now are just lineal footages, but this could be counts, areas, all the same type of dimensions that I measured over an on-screen takeoff, I could actually bring up to do something else with and so forth. So that way, if I want to bring over square footage of flooring or number of doors or anything of that nature. So that is one method where I can go through and actually just bring in the whole entire list from the on-screen takeoff all in one moment and then just drop them from within estimating, pull up a list, pick them to drop them into whatever buckets I want to in the estimating. Another way of doing it is actually just bring things over as you need them. So for example, if I go into a wall again, and let's say I was doing some sort of exterior wall again, and I get to a point that needs to know length. This icon here stands for E-Plan Takeoff. The first time I click on it, it figures out that I'm already in the project. Is that the project I would like to use? And me by saying yes, will know that this project is associated with that now. What it has also done is it's now added a new icon to my on-screen takeoff here called Send Value. So if I highlight this 696 and hit send value, that has just automatically brought that back into my other screen or my other window here. Now this is where having two monitors are kind of handy, because that way I could go off and just go to my on-screen takeoff, hit send dimension, have that send it over to estimating, and just kind of work between those two screens and so forth, instead of me having to click down here at the bottom from one to the other to navigate between here. But I could go off and answer the rest of whatever my questions may have been and so forth, and that type of thing for my takeoff. And then I could come back up here and say, okay, well, I need another wall. And maybe I don't necessarily have to click on this every time. Once I've done it once, it knows the association with this project. So now I could say, okay, well, I want this 46 foot, send that value. That'll basically bring that 46 back into my assembly. And now I could go off and answer whatever was different about that type of wall. Those type of things. So now when I accept it, now I've got some more takeoff in my estimate with the ones that I kind of did earlier and the ones that I just did there a moment ago. And if I come back and review these assemblies, it's kind of handy, because that way I could tell there's pass one, the date and time of when I did it, there was some dimension, it was used on-screen takeoff to come up with the number. If I click on that particular button, it'll actually bring on-screen takeoff up. It'll actually move the cursor to that particular cell and say there's where that 696 foot came into play, that type of thing. So it's just a quick way of bringing a number dimension over from on screen into estimating, but yet also give me an awesome audit trail that I can actually go back into the image to tell where it came from. Now, one warning though is if somebody went back and modified the drawing, that does not necessarily go back and just change the estimate to whatever the value is or things of that nature. So in this case here, where I had 600 some foot in both my estimate already, if somebody were to come back and do any more takeoff, so let's just make up that for some reason this was wall type one or something like that too, so now I'm well over 700 foot, my estimate is still based on whatever my estimate was. So it's not a direct link or anything of that nature. It basically just brings it over to get me started with. So it is something that if anyone comes back and changes the dimensions, I've got to be very careful with it. Now, it does also mean that I could come back to the new dimension, highlight it, tell it to send that value so it sends my 783 back over to my estimating, tell it to replace that pass, and that way I could tell 221 when I did that, it was 696 foot, but when I came back to replace that pass one, it was really 783. And now when I accept it and go back to my spreadsheet, it's got all my new numbers and so forth. So that is basically how you can get information, either pull all the numbers over in one shot from on-screen takeoff, or I can basically bring the numbers over one by one as I position where I want them in estimating. So if I had something like an individual item in the spreadsheet that needed to know the lineal footage of the walls or something like that, so maybe I didn't have assemblies built, maybe we're just doing a bunch of one-time items and my items look like something very generic. I need a quantity, it's going to be lineal foot, it's going to have some labor material to it, so here's an item in my estimate. So I could do the same thing just to the spreadsheet. So if I said, well, here's that particular 358 lineal foot, send that value, it'll just look at wherever I'm at in estimating, and it basically just sent that value right back to that particular cell. So it could be dropped back into assemblies, dropped back into items, dropped back into models, those type of things. So basically where the cursor is where it's going to drop that value back into. So take a look at the on-screen takeoff and the interface with it.